You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Sedes ad dexteram patris.
the memorial of the Immaculate Mother of God, may with the help of her intercession rise up from our iniquities. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever.
Amen.
But you may savour with delight her glorious breasts. For thus says the Lord, now towards her I send flowing peace like a river, and like a stream in spate, the glory of the nations. At her breast will be her nurslings, be carried and fondled in her lap. Like a son comforted by his mother, will I comfort you. And by Jerusalem you will be comforted. At the sight your heart will rejoice, and your bones will flourish like the grass. To his servants the Lord will be in his hand. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Bless the Lord, you Virgin Mary. Capernaum in Galilee. The mother of Jesus was there, and Jesus and his disciples had also been invited. When they ran out of wine, since the wine provided for the wedding was all finished, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." Jesus said, "Woman, why turn to me? My hour has not come yet." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." There were 6 stone water jars standing there, meant for the ablutions that are customary among the Jews. Each could hold 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jars with water," and they filled them to the brim. "Draw some out now," he told them, "and take it to the steward." They did this. The steward tasted the water, and it had turned into wine. Having no idea where it came from, only the servants who had drawn the water knew, the steward called the bridegroom and said, "People generally serve the best wine first and keep the cheaper sort till the guests have had plenty to drink. But you have kept the best wine till now." This was the first of the signs given by Jesus. It was given at Cana in Galilee. He let his glory be seen, and his disciples believed in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Be to God.
Responded And then we heard, we choose this man, our brother, for the order of deacons. And all of us here are witnesses to this. Called and chosen, as you were when you were called into being and chosen to be part of God's family. Called and chosen, precious in the eyes of the Lord and dear to him. Listen now to what the Lord is saying to you, his chosen one. Like a son comforted by his mother, will I comfort you. And by Jerusalem you will be comforted. At the sight your heart will rejoice, and your bones flourish like the grass. To his servant the Lord will reveal his hand. In the days to come, should you ever doubt the Lord's love for you, remember these encouraging words and let them bring you strength and courage. For you will need strength and courage, as do all those whom the Lord has called and chosen. Hold on to the fact that on this, the feast of Our Lady of Lourdes, the Lord gave you heart through his word. Treasure it and ponder it and live it. Yes, you're certainly called and chosen by the Lord, but so that he can send you. In a moment or two, we will hear the prayer of consecration. Lord, look with favour on this servant of yours, whom we now dedicate to the office of deacon, to minister at your holy altar. May he in his life imitate your son, who came not to be served, but to serve, and one day reign with him in heaven. So you are sent to serve in the Lord's name. What will that service entail? If we're to follow Jesus in serving his people, then we will be asked to give our all, to give our lives, just as the Master gave his. If I'm coming together here this lunchtime, this special afternoon has a purpose. It's to celebrate and seal the connection between the Lord surrendering himself for our salvation and the contribution of your lives to form part of that great act of redeeming service. You are about to dedicate your life to Christ and his people by making a commitment to live the rest of your life in the celibate state, which will be both a sign and the motive of your pastoral love. The love of Christ and his people will be your goal, your strength, your sustenance, your joy, and your consolation. It will lift you when you fall down. It will urge you on when you want to stop. It will refresh you when you're weary. And it will support and be your staff throughout your life. Give your life, give your heart to Christ today, and be prepared to offer it again tomorrow, and the day after, and the day after that for the rest of your life, so that you can live and serve in freedom with an undivided heart. And in this way, the simplest everyday things will become a powerful witness of your dedication to the service of the Lord and his people. And he is squirming a little bit inside. I'm only human, you say. That's a tall order for anyone. Left to myself, I'll find all that very hard. But you won't be left to yourself. In the name of the whole church, we all of us here pray, Lord, send forth upon him the Holy Spirit, that he may be strengthened by the gift of your sevenfold grace to carry out faithfully the work of ministry. Rest assured that all of us are praying for you now and in the future. The best advice I can offer you is the same advice that Mary offered the servants at the wedding feast at Cana, and that gospel that we heard just a few moments ago. Do whatever he tells you. In that way, you will find that the water of your life is turned into the rich wine of sharing in the ministry of Jesus itself. And as you grow older in the work of the Lord, and more experienced, convinced of how he can work marvels through you, so you will realize also that he has been saving the best wine until last. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
By your own free choice, you seek to enter the order of deacons. You shall exercise this ministry in the celibate state. The celibacy is both a sign and a motive for pastoral charity, and a special source of spiritual fruitfulness in the world. By living in this state with total dedication, moved by a sincere love for Christ the Lord, you are consecrated to him in a new and special way. By this consecration, you will adhere more easily to Christ with an undivided heart. You will be more freely at the service of God and humankind, and you will be more untrammeled in the ministry of Christian conversion and rebirth. By your life and character, you will give witness to your brothers and sisters in faith that God must be loved above all else, and that it is he whom you serve in others. Therefore I ask you, in the presence of God and the Church, are you resolved, as a sign of your interior dedication to Christ, to remain celibate for the rest, for the sake of the kingdom, and in lifelong service to God and mankind?
I am.
May the Lord help you to persevere in this commitment.
Amen.
My son, before you are ordained a deacon, you must declare before the people your intention to undertake this office. Are you willing to be ordained for the Church's ministry by the laying on of hands and the gift of the Holy Spirit?
I am.
Are you resolved to discharge the office of deacon with humility and love in order to assist the bishop and the priest and to serve the people of Christ?
I am.
Are you resolved to hold the mystery of the faith with a clear conscience, as the Apostle urges, and to proclaim this faith in word and action as it is taught by the Gospel and the Church's tradition?
I am.
Are you resolved to maintain and deepen a spirit of prayer appropriate to your way of life, and in keeping with what is required of you, to celebrate faithfully the liturgy of the hours for the Church and for the whole world?
I am.
Are you resolved to shape your way of life always according to the example of Christ, whose body and blood you will give to the people?
I am, with the help of God.
Do you promise respect and obedience to your order?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. My dear people, let us pray that the all-powerful Father will pour out his blessing on this servant of his whom he receives into the holy order of deacons.
Let us kneel.
Lord, have mercy.
and patriarchs,
pray for us.
Saint Peter and Saint Paul,
pray for us.
Saint Andrew,
pray for us.
Saint James,
pray for us.
Saint John,
pray for us.
Saint Jude,
pray for us.
For you apostles and evangelists,
pray for us.
Saint Stephen,
pray for us.
Saint Lawrence,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Antioch,
pray for us.
Saint Alban,
pray for us.
Saint Perpetua and Saint Felicity,
pray for us.
Blessed Titus Brandsman,
pray for us. Yeah.
bless him and make him holy. Grant this to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray.
Almighty God, be present with us by your power. You are the source of all honour. You assign to each his rank and give to each his ministry. You remain unchanged, but you watch over all creation and make it new through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. He is your word, your power and your wisdom. You foresee all things in your eternal providence. Make due provision for every age. You make the Church, Christ's body, grow to its full stature as a new and greater temple. You enrich it with every kind of grace, and perfect it with a diversity of members, to serve the whole body in a wonderful pattern of unity. You establish the threefold ministry of worship and service for the glory of your name. As ministers of your tabernacle, you chose the sons of Levi and gave them your blessing as their everlasting inheritance. In the first days of your church, under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, the apostles of your Son appointed seven men of good repute to assist them in the daily ministry, so that they themselves might be more free for prayer and preaching. By prayer and the laying on of hands, the apostles entrusted to those chosen men in ministry a serving of tables. Lord, look with favour on this servant of yours, whom we now dedicate to the office of deacon, to minister at your holy altar. Lord, send forth upon him the Holy Spirit, that he may be strengthened by the gift of your sevenfold grace, to carry out faithfully the work of the ministry. May he excel in every virtue, in love that is sincere, in concern for the sick and the poor, in unassuming authority, in self-discipline, and in holiness of life. May his conduct exemplify your commandments, and lead your people to imitate his purity of life. May he remain strong and steadfast in Christ, giving to the world the witness of a pure conscience. May he, in this life, imitate your Son, who came not to be served, but to serve, and one day reign with him in heaven. We ask this for our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you now are. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. at yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all the Church.
Receive, O Lord, we ask, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that through the intercession of Blessed Mary, the mother of your Son, no petition may go unanswered, no request be made in vain. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's end, you have done great things, and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us, through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the hosts of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Chalice to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and drink from it, For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, the saints of Carmel, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Pope Benedict, our Pope, and Terence Patrick, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command, that formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I give you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not afraid to be shed on my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. Let us pray. As we receive this heavenly sacrament, we beseech you, O Lord, your mercy, that we who rejoice in commemorating the Blessed Virgin Mary may, by imitating her, serve worthily the mystery of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So I'd just like to congratulate Jen on behalf of us all. You don't get congratulations very often, so enjoy it. Let's congratulate you.
Thank you.